Hey, Shalom, Shalom, Mishpoka. Welcome to another edition of Rav Ash's Ramblings. I'm your host, Rabbi Yehuda Ben Shomer. And today, in honor of the secular year's date, 10-10-10, I'm going to talk to you about the number 10. And I'm going to be reading a select passage from the Pirkei Avot, which is the rabbinical writings of called the Ethics of the Father. And it's going to be from chapter 5, verses 1 all the way to verse 8. And there was a very short-lived TV game show that came on primetime by Drew Carey called The Power of 10. And if anybody ever watches David Letterman, you know, he always has, you know, the top 10 whatever. Well, God has his top 10 too. And God has his power of 10. And I'm about to read it to you right now. It says, "With 10 utterances, the world was created. What does this come to teach us? Indeed, could it not have been created with one utterance? That was to exact punishment from the wicked who destroyed the world that was created with 10 utterances, and to bestow goodly reward upon the righteous who sustained the world that was created by 10 utterances. There were 10 generations from Adam to Noah to show the degree of his patience. For all those generations angered him increasingly until he brought about the waters of the flood. There were 10 generations from Noah to Abraham to show the degree of his patience. For all those generations angered him increasingly until our forefather Abraham came and received the reward of them all. Our forefather Abraham was tested with 10 trials, and he withstood them all to show the degree of our forefather Abraham's love for God. 10 miracles were performed for our ancestors in Egypt, and 10 at the sea, and 10 plagues did the Holy One, blessed be He, bring upon the Egyptians, and in Egypt, and 10 at the sea. With 10 trials did our ancestors test the Holy One, blessed be He, in the wilderness. As it is said, they have tested me these 10 times and did not heed my voice." Numbers 14:22. 10 miracles were performed for our ancestors in the Holy Temple. No women miscarried because of the aroma of the sacrificial meat. The sacrificial meat never became putrid, nor no fly was seen in the place where the meat was butchered. No seminal emission occurred to the high priest on Yom Kippur. The rains did not extinguish the fire on the altar pyre, and the wind did not disperse the vertical column of smoke from the altar. No disqualification was found in the omer, or in the two loaves, or in the showbread. The people stood crowded together, yet prostrated themselves in ample space. Neither serpent nor scorpion ever caused injury in Jerusalem. Nor did any man say to his fellow, this space is insufficient for me to stay overnight in Jerusalem. 10 things were created on Sabbath Eve at twilight. They are the mouth of the earth, the mouth of the well, the mouth of the donkey, the rainbow, which was Noah's sign that there would be no more future floods, the manna, the staff, the shamir worm, the script, the inscription, and the tablets. Some say also destructive spirits, Moses' grave, and the ram of our forefather Abraham. And some also say tongs, which were made with tongs. Not only that, but we also know that we have the 10 words, which Christians call the 10 commandments, which are not an exhaustive account of God's laws for mankind or God's instructions for mankind. If you take the equation of how many commandments the rabbis and sages have determined are in the Torah, which are 613, you take 6 plus 1 plus 3, that equals 10. So in other words, the 10 commandments sum up the 613. And if you take 1 plus 0, it equals 1. And that one commandment, the greatest commandment, to love Yud Heh Vav Heh with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And Yeshua said the second is just as important as the first. It's like unto it, love your neighbor as yourself. So if you keep the greatest commandment and that commandment that's equal to the greatest commandment, you'll by default automatically be keeping the 10. And if you keep the 10, you'll be keeping the 613. So it's very interesting how that mathematical equation works out. And I just thought this video would be very appropriate for this being October 10th, 2010, the date 10-10-10. When is that ever going to happen again in any of our lifetimes? So thanks for watching. Shalom and Shavua Tov. Bye-bye.